Hey guys, I know Lauren kind of covered her morning routine last week, so I figure I dive into mine. It's kind of interesting because everyone's is kind of different. So honestly, I kind of created my morning routine based off a book I read that was The Miracle Morning. It's an awesome book. He just kind of gives you his principles of how he develops his morning routine, and I took that and kind of created my own. So ultimately, you know, I wake up pretty early. I shoot for about 4, 4:30. I know it sounds crazy, but I got a pretty hectic day, so it's kind of nice to get some quiet time to myself. So yeah, so I wake up, I actually end up stretching and rolling out for about 5-10 minutes, and then I meditate for about 5-10 minutes. Just some quiet time, keep the mind calm. There's an awesome app that you guys can use. It's called Headspace. So it's a meditation app. It's actually a really good app. So I do that, and then after that, I actually spend a little bit of time filling out my best self journal. It's really cool. It talks about like your goals for the day, your targets for the day, and then kind of plan out my day so I have a good idea of what I'm going into. So I like doing that a lot. And then after that, you know, typically I get Lauren's butt out of bed, and we head to go do cardio. And then while I do cardio, I actually read. I know it's crazy. Everyone kind of asks how I do that and not get dizzy. I have no idea. I just don't get dizzy when I do it. So that's where I can kind of crank through a lot of books. So yeah, that's kind of my morning routine as far as that goes, you know, so I like to, yeah, wake up, stretch, meditate, plan out my day. And then also cardio and reading. And sometimes if I can, I'll check some emails and get a little bit of work done before I head off to cardio as well. So just kind of, again, quiet time in the morning. You know, I got a hectic lifestyle, so sometimes it's nice to just get up really early and it's quiet and just me time. So I like that. As far as night routine, not as good at that. I finish up my, you know, self-planner. Or my self journal, best self journal. You know, what were the wins for the day? What did you accomplish? And then we normally dive into some Vikings, to be honest with you. It's a great show. So yeah, if you guys want to see a little bit of our chest workout and some posing at Armbrust Pro Gym down in down Denver, keep watching. So thanks, guys.
Careful, you don't want this. Carefree, but there's a dark side that haunts this. Paparazzi gossip loves to watch this, but drugs take me away when I pop this. Rock and roll lifestyle at a fast pace. Roy like a NASCAR in a drag race. Zoom, zoom, why the fuck are you in last place? Need to catch up.
We didn't film at Armbrust.
Got a little excited.
Forgot. So we'll film next weekend, or yeah,
two weeks
from now.
Every other week.
But we just kind of slightly forgot. But with that said, we're going to dive into, we had a few questions on flexible dieting.
Yeah, so someone left a comment, I think it was 2 weeks ago, on flexible dieting. This one was, it's kind of a little bit more of a controversial subject, so we kind of want to address it
gently.
On its own video. And a little gently, because everyone does have opinions, so we're not trying to smash those opinions. And if that's your style, awesome. All the power to you. But someone asked how we feel about it. So personally, how we feel about it. We're kind of on the same page. I don't think it's the most efficient way to prep. Personally, I think it's not a terrible lifestyle diet if you wanted to incorporate it into your lifestyle. You'd still be able to enjoy, you know, certain treats, but it's not, I don't think you could take it to the level of a prep.
Well, and prep or lifestyle, it's not being like, oh, I'm going to eat cereal for every meal, I'm going to eat ice cream for every meal, I'm going to do this. You're not getting the same nutritional value out of those foods as you would out of a whole food. So it's still a moderation thing. You can't eat a whole diet based off of ice cream and sweets and treats and this and this. Because there's no way that 18 grams of sugar is the same 18 grams of like oatmeal or like rice or potatoes. Like, it just, that doesn't cross over right to give you the same nutrients or give you the same results. Because like, you're going to hold water differently. You're going to hold fat differently. Everything's going to, your body's going to respond to those differently because they're processed foods for one. Two, you're just not going to come down the way you want because, like I said, your body's going to hold them as processed foods. So they're really...
They're not whole foods.
No.
You know? So I think there's... even if you do flexible dieting, which if you don't know what flexible dieting is, it's incorporating the ability to eat the same amount of carbohydrates depending on what... It doesn't matter what carb it's coming from. So it could be Captain Crunch or oatmeal. It's 18 carbs. You have 18 carbs of each, which... we just don't think it's the same. And the reason, you know, the science behind, for me, is when you talk about the glycemic index, it's certain foods break down and affect your insulin levels differently. So sugars are going to have a higher glycemic index. So they're going to affect insulin levels more greatly. And insulin can cause you to store fat. So, you know, Captain Crunch and oatmeal, you know, oatmeal's going to have a slower digestion, give you longer sustained energy, whereas Captain Crunch is going to have a higher one. So I don't know why I like those examples, but I feel like I've seen that a lot. So yes. So I don't think it's a terrible thing. I just don't think it's the most efficient way to bring your body down the best. Because like Lauren said, it is, you know, when you're changing into processed foods, it's going to affect hormones. It's going to have, you know, different mineral counts, like, you know, salt and all that kind of stuff. Mm-hmm. So it's going to affect you differently than something of a whole food that's more natural. So not to be kind of hippie, but I think the natural foods are going to respond a little bit better to your body. So that's our opinion. But again, it's our opinion.
Yes.
So
yeah,
that's kind of how we feel about it.
Eat whole foods.
Thanks, guys.
And with that said, we're going to go ahead and close this for the week. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Go follow both of us on Instagram, Atlas on Instagram as well. Like I said, leave comments what you guys want to see, but we will be back next week with something else for you. See ya.
Thanks, guys.